I am Fernanda Cantone, and I am Assistant Professor in Technology of Architecture at the University of Catania, Italy. My contribute is Cultural Heritage and Enhancement for an Eco Museum in Tre Castagne, near Etna, Sicily. Introduction: Tangible Heritage. The Italian word for heritage derives from the Latin word patrimonium, originating from the word pater, patris, which means father. It is defined as the set of riches, tangible and intangible values that belong to a community or a single individual, as they were inherited or are part of tradition. In some cases, the concept of heritage has unfortunately become an instrument to remove people's identities, an instrument of mass destruction, of ransom. It is above all the expression of a conflict between oblivion and memory. Protection and abuse between viola-le-duc and Ruskin, between present and future, between stock and heritage, tourism and museums, between economics and accuracy, and between technique and art. Nowadays, the debate is about building or tangible heritage, a term that goes beyond the concept of cultural heritage and indicates full awareness about the substantial unity and structure of the same culture that expresses itself through different linguistic structures, yet all belonging to a single code of expression. Tangible heritage recognizes an overlapping of traces and testimonies that make it something to be protected, but also available to the public. Heritage should be considered as a book to read and learn from, as a past container that can be reused and transformed, not only an empty shell to be preserved. The instrument par excellence is enhancement. Enhancement means increasing the value of a cultural asset, but above all, transforming an asset into value, that is, to express the full potential of the cultural asset, its material and immaterial values. In other words, to increase the appreciation of the cultural values and to recognize the public use of the asset. Enhancement undertakes action that increase value. These are cultural operations that can promote conservation and cultural and building assets. Enhancement deals with the physical data and its transformation, its functionality and usability. Enhancement includes educational purposes closely linked to the heritage in order to improve the knowledge and consequently also the conservation of cultural and environmental assets, increasing their usability. The main purpose of enhancement is also to provide guidelines and promote the coordination of good practices in collaboration with the services of the peripheral structures of the administration operating in the territory, as well as other administration and territorial authorities, in order to give an increasingly significant role to local identities. The integrated supply of resources can also generate direct and economic impacts. With the outsourcing of activities and services related to its management, as well as in indirect impacts. The latter results not only from the evident impact to the tourist industry, but also from the fact that the system that develops around the heritage increases the competitiveness of a territory, making it capable of attracting more than other human and financial resources, increasing tourism, as well as the establishment of productive activities not necessarily belonging to the cultural sector. In short, we must utilize all assets to their maximum potential, and the creation of eco museums is the optimal way of exploding the integrated values. Eco Museum. An eco museum represents an innovative cultural project aimed at valorizing a specific region or a privileged context where there is a tight connection between mankind and nature. Hugues de Varine affirmed that an ecomuseum is an institution that manages, studies, uses for scientific, educational and cultural purposes the overall heritage of a community, including the whole of its natural and cultural environment. Therefore, an ecomuseum is a tool which promotes the people's participation in the management of a region and in the development of a local community. First of all, it is done on purpose in order to trigger some changes. The ecomuseum is intended to teach people how to work together, to trust each other, to acquire confidence when dealing with other players, be they public or private, to create and guarantee the functioning of groups promoting projects. In doing so, it can turn a population of individuals into a real community. Tercastagni Eco Museum will stimulate the participation of local residents and the member of this community who can guarantee the same condition necessary for local development and in particular the management of the common heritage. Tercastagni Eco Museum is aimed at training citizens to become the players that will trigger the development and social change. Such training will generate mutual capacity and knowledge among all citizens that will turn into common action starting from the shared heritage. It is a cultural exchange aimed at interaction in order to cooperate. In this regard, some minimum requirements are introduced that are necessary to meet the goals to this research and are drawn from the study by Andreas Jorgensen. They represent the main elements included in the project. The existence of an information center, several sites to be visited with exhibition, like for example Panoramic Viewpoint Multimedia Museum. Workshop promoting the active participation of visitors, like educational settings, and connection with the surrounding environment, green places, human facility, historical dwellings, and theme, routes and pathways, sound, olfactory, tactile journeys, naturalistic tours. The case study is Trecastagni, a small town near Catania, Sicily, Italy, at the foot of Mount Etna, a volcano declared a World Heritage Site in 2013. Trecastagni has an ancient past whose traces are now lost. Archive sources mention a town called Tres Castagnes in 1357. For a few hundred years, Trecastagni was under the control of the Bishop of Catania and subject to the to periodic visit. The reports of this visit, in particular one in 1640 and one in 1655, describe Trecastagni as a populous and rich village with 3,400 inhabitants, grouped into 770 families. The town developed along the north-south directions and went from the district of Santa Caterina to the church of Sant'Alfio, with winding street and jumps of altitude, typical of the medieval plant. There is the presence of the majestic staircase of the Comblat matrix among the useful information. In 1640, the territory of Trecastagni was sold to a wealthy merchant from Messina, Domenico di Giovanni, from the sum of 30,000 scudi. He settled in Trecastagni with the title of prince. In 1693, earthquake destroyed most of the buildings, causing at least 500 deaths. The reconstruction, starting from 1700, is impressive. Religious and civil buildings were built in the areas of the main streets. The 19th century marked great changes. Monastic orders were abolished and many religious buildings were ceded to administration. Mayor controlled the town and carried out works of improvement on streets, squares and public buildings. In this period, the first cemetery was planned. Since the 1950s, Trecastagna has been a destination for second home tourism. This phenomenon has led to the development of many plots of land and the construction of a large numbers of villas with gardens. These are located in the southern part of the town, where is an unparalleled view of the sea and on the road to Pedara and Monterosso. Despite construction speculation, greenery is still present. Private gardens are a feature of these places. Trecastagni is considered a cultural, natural and architectural landscape and reflects the combined work of nature and humanity. The research. The research aimed to identify tools to enhance territories with complex form of cultural, historical, natural, anthropogenic, constructive, social and economic values. Following the principles of valorization, the potential of the context was surveyed starting from the cultural heritage. In short, through the search of tangible and intangible heritage, buildings, places and traditions have been identified that make Trecastagni a unique place. By doing so, the constructed system, the landscape system and the intangible system were taken into account. The constructed system is made up of all the buildings that express historical, artistic, cultural and material values. Among them, there are valuable examples of late 19th century dwellings that constitute an important part of the historic center of Trecastagni. The architectural models of the building have been analyzed within the constructed system and they have been classified into two-span, three-span, five-span buildings. Within these models, submodels have been identified that present a small variation in scheme. Further details were made on the portals in lava stone and white stone and on the road surfaces. The latter appear in different configuration, almost all of which can be traced back to the past, which have been detected in their morphological and technological components. The landscape system includes the agriculture and forest landscape. The intangible system includes oral tradition, literature, patronal feast, craft, and an important collection of ex voto, gift to the church for a miracle that has been granted. All these elements, many of which are of great interest, converge in a system of values that must be valued. Knowing the limits of a traditional plant museum for such a vast collection of goods and traditions, the choice fell on the Eco Museum to verify the real possibility of the creation of an Eco Museum in Trecastagni. The criteria of a checklist, a table of scopes that accredits points to goods and traditions, was utilized. Such findings clearly indicate that an eco-museum could be the right choice. A project, however, is not made only of purposes. To become a success, it must take into account the characteristic of the territory, the demands of the community, and the possibilities of economic improvement. The three pillars of the sustainable development triangle must be involved: economy, environment, and society. Thus, the Eco Museum project must create opportunities for comparison between visitors and the resident population, promote research activities, educational project, and audiovisual documentation initiatives. From an operational point of view, initiatives of intergenerational social encounter have been promoted in order to understand the needs of different groups of users, but also to recover traditional techniques and workers and define a correct relationship between consumption and renewal of resources. On the constructed system, the intervention concerned the district of Giovanni, part of the historical center, characterized by a tortuous layout and simple buildings, often for productive use. A public space called Piano Pucita and the warehouses of the Prince Palace. The first project concerned the area created around the palace of the Prince di Giovanni, a 17th century building currently being restored and destined to become a museum of contemporary art. Beside the Palace di Giovanni, several abandoned warehouses are present, all require a recovery intervention and a new purpose of utilization. Old roads covered by asphalt will be restored in a contemporary way, with modern materials, retaining their old features, but at the same time with a modern functionality. Shedding will be created by using a structure in concrete and steel covered by climbing plants such as wisteria, which are common feature in Sicilian garden in this area. Outdoor seating and waste disposal being have also been designed in cotton steel. The second project involves the redevelopment of a large public space, known as Piano Pucita, to create a green and equipped space suitable for all age groups. The project aims to create a wide stepped staircase with a dual functionality. Not only a staircase, but as a large seating area to watch open-air performances from a large stage created at a lower level. The project also included placing benches under the existing trees, the creation of a skate park, an area for the local market and parking, all in harmony and safeguarding the existing greenery. The third project concerned the reuse of the warehouse of the Palace of the Prince di Giovanni, where the headquarters of the Eco Museum, the Archive, the Documentation Center, study and meeting rooms, recreational function such as bar and restaurant will be located. For the environmental system tour in the city and the natural trails in the woods, a gave been projected. Both tours have a network of a complete facilities such as historic buildings to visit, place to eat, small business, visit and testing at the wineries and food companies to create unforgettable memories. All in full respect of the building's heritage, natural heritage, and intangible heritage. In conclusion, one of the most important preconditions of the success of an enhancement project in the protection of the natural and man-made landscape, if the integrity of landscapes is to be protected, valorization must provide economic benefit. Furthermore, it will succeed only if it includes all three pillars of the sustainable development triangle, economy, environment, and society. To access the economy pressures that could result from the valorization activities in the future, it's necessary to identify innovative and sustainable intervention before the tourist pressure intensifies. The enhancement strategy emphasizes that Tre Castagni is rich in natural and anthropogenic resources. The system of historical building, of agriculture and traditions. Thanks to the interest in site with little transformation, quiet and rich in history and nature, the enhancement project provides excellent conditions for the success of the initiative and proposes a modified landscape whose characteristics allow the allocation of attractive and economically advantageous functions, but also satisfactory for the community. In fact, the development project must provide scope for the realization of sustainable activities in such a way as to remain viable for as long as possible in relation to the climate and tourist flows. The ecomuseum must leave the environment unaltered, natural, social and artistic, and not prevent the development of other social and economic activities. The sustainability of the project requires full respect for the fragile balance that characterizes many sites rich in history, architecture,